Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7.
What's up, dudes? Max here, and I got something special for a game that I've been waiting to play for years now. I got an arcade mode playthrough of Tekken 7 using Jin, and I got this because the Bandai Namco dudes were kind enough to take me up to their offices and let me play a whole bunch of the game and capture it. Like I just said, this is a full arcade mode playthrough, and there's some pretty interesting stuff that kind of happens in between, so I'm curious if anyone has seen an actual full arcade mode playthrough on Tekken 7 Faded Retribution. If it's any different, leave me a comment below, because I'm kind of curious, because there's something a little crazy that happens in the end that leads me to think I missed something. But talking about the game in general, this is the most I've had a chance to play Tekken 7 since E3 last year. This has been a game that I have been watching in online streams and Korean streams that actually have the game, the actual full arcade version that stream it every single night, Green Tekken / Green Arcade. I've just been watching these streams for what feels like years now, even though it's probably been less than a year. The situation is that Tekken 7 has been out in arcades for quite some time, and Tekken 7 Faded Retribution, which is the Tekken 7 we are getting, the full updated version. But now we have more characters like Eliza, the vampire girl, we also get Eddie and things like that. But I've been watching so much of the game that I feel like it's been out for a long time. So a lot of my excitement towards certain things has sort of waned because I feel like I've been engrossed around the game for so much of that time that until you finally play it, until like since E3 of last year, I finally got a chance to touch the game, to figure out the combos, to understand screws and how all the new combo structures and everything like that works, where I really started enjoying it, finding the meat and bones of how the game controls itself, and relearning how to play Tekken over again has actually been a whole bunch of fun. There are a few characters I'm looking forward to using. Jin, of course, is my main number one character, all the way since my competitive days in Tekken 3 back in 1998, and then I'm desperately looking forward to getting really good with Akuma. I want to try to learn Lars, even though I hear he's not great, and maybe I'll use a little bit of Kazumi because I love the fact that she actually uses tigers in most of her attacks. But talking about the gameplay itself, after fresh off playing a whole bunch of Tekken 3 and Tekken 5, which are the primary Tekkens that we have been playing over on the stream for quite some time, I feel like we fire those games up every once a month or so and just play Tekken 3 or Tekken 5. I was never a huge fan of Tekken 6 or beyond, so Tekken 6 as well as Tekken Tag Tournament 2, I never really had a chance to blend with well, because Tekken Tag 2 was in a unique situation where so much was similar to Tekken 6 and everyone was so damn good at the game. And Tekken 6 came out at a point where I was super excited for it, but the netplay was just really bad at the time. And with that being said, the last time I was ever really invested into the Tekken series was going all the way back to Tekken 5 and Tekken 5 Dark Resurrection, which I played a whole bunch of way back in the day. So this is the first opportunity where I'm super excited to play Tekken again, and after playing it, it makes me realize how much I miss proper 3D fighters. The biggest thing about this game is the movement, making your character actually be more mobile than they inherently are, because that is a huge aspect of Tekken, moving around the screen, making yourself safe, ducking attacks, everything like that, backdashing. All this stuff is super important, and for the past few years, whenever we've gone back to play Tekken 3 or Tekken 5, I've been playing them on controller, and I learned quickly that I have to play this game on an arcade stick. Arcade stick is absolutely the way to go for Tekken 7, for me personally, but if you're used to controller, the game is obviously designed around it with the four face buttons, and the game was initially a Sony console fighting game. So it's built inherently for the fact that it is for controllers too, but at the same time, with all the mobility that is one of the hardest things to do in Tekken, I find it just so much easier to do it on an arcade stick, and I'm not even really good at it at all by any means yet. I'm still learning a whole bunch of things. I'm still trying to learn how to consistently get electrics off and everything like that, but the thing that's the most important is that landing moves, playing the game, and actually playing its neutral is super fun. And one of the bigger things that I know a lot of people are excited about, and I am too because of just the way it's implemented, is the Mishima Saga, like, proper story mode, the huge story mode that Tekken has kind of had in other games, and now it's way bigger than it ever has been. However, when I did play through arcade mode with some characters, they are general arcade ladders, although I have not seen endings for characters yet, so I'm not too sure if that's something that you have to unlock, because there are moments where you don't get a full final boss fight, and there are different bosses in the end, so I'm kind of curious how that goes. I know one of the big number one questions all of you guys would have regarding Tekken 7 is netcode, and it's the thing that I was first asking all the guys at Bandai Namco about, and they do not have any information to give out right now, and we have to wait a little bit closer to launch. But from what I'm understanding and what has been said a lot before, the arcade versions of Tekken 7 Faded Retribution actually use netplay for the majority of the machines. You play people in other arcades on Tekken 7 Faded Retribution, and it's not just local side-by-side or cabinet-to-cabinet co-op. You can play multitudes of other people around a variety of locations, and I'm fairly sure it's going to be using similar netcode. One thing I did notice is that there is an inherent frame delay to Tekken 7, where if you press a button, there is a delay of a few frames from you pressing the button to actually seeing activity on the screen. I'm gonna say it's like maybe 3 to 4 frames or something like that, but it's cooked into the whole game. Like, even the offline modes have that, which is very similar to what happened with Tekken Tag Tournament 2, where there was a bunch of pre-canned early buffer frames that they can use to make the netplay run a bit smoother, and it's a very similar situation to Tekken 7. Really, if the online for Tekken 7 was just a more improved version of Tekken Tag Tournament 2, or even in a similar range of Tag Tournament 2, I think that would be great. The thing that really didn't appeal to me to Tag 2 was the tag mechanics, figuring out the tag system, utilizing all of it, and having to learn a multitude of characters and how those characters work together with each other. It just became a little much, and I really enjoyed one-on-one Tekken, which is what Tekken 7 is providing. Either way, I can't wait to jump online and start playing these games and get my butt whipped and learn all over again how to play Tekken, but I think it's going to be a lot of fun because there's going to be more new people playing Tekken now than there has been in the past 10 years, if you really think about it. But let me know in the comments below what you guys want to see in terms of some content. I do have some more footage available of some super arts, so you can actually see all the rage arts that are in the game, which are the proper super moves that characters have, which do add a very interesting dynamic to Tekken that has not really been there before, unless you count the free-to-play version that was on PlayStation, and it's heavily tweaked in this one. And I also have another playthrough that Mark did with me of Eddie, where he knows quite a bit about Eddie and his combos, so if you guys are looking forward to seeing some Eddie footage and some full combo strings he has, because I don't know if there's a lot out there right now, let me know in the comments below as well. Thank you dudes a ton for watching. I'll be back with more Tekken 7 footage and updates as soon as possible, and one of the next things I definitely want to do is a full arcade mode playthrough using Akuma. Stay tuned guys, enjoy the rest of this gameplay without any commentary, and I'll see you next time.
Fight.
KO. Round 2. Fight.